we know as a country the importance of investing in young children.
Because we genuinely believe in the power of education to shape lives.
When their stories are told, it impacts not just the teacher, the school, it impacts the communities and the districts. Teachers Making a Difference is part of our Ugandan Making a Difference program. We have other projects under the Ugandans Making a Difference program, which include the Best Farmers, Teachers Making a Difference, Women Achievers, and Youth Entrepreneurs. On some of them, we've been more consistent than the others, but our intention is to recognize all Ugandans who are making a difference in their areas of practice. So we started this program in 2008, and Teachers Making a Difference has been running for 15 years.
For us, rewarding teachers is very important. Ireland knows from its own experience that investing in education is key to economic development. We have a long history in working in education here. When I was here 20 years ago, I actually chaired the Education Donor Group, so it's great to come back and see the fruits of those investments. We invest in Karamoja, where we see the benefits of the school bursary systems, investments in infrastructure in schools. And when I go back 20 years, the number of people that I meet that have been on our bursary schemes or who have gone to school in some of the classrooms, and Uganda has a huge population of young people, and we need to invest in them to make sure that they have the skills and the talents necessary to develop themselves, but also to develop the country.
Private companies are in business to make money or to make profit, and we are no different at Travelcare. We're a small business, however, we do recognise that companies like ourselves can play a positive role in addressing social issues. So we balance our profit goals with a sense of social responsibility, creating a meaningful and sustainable impact. We've been involved with the New Vision and the Embassy of Ireland in supporting the Teachers Making a Difference initiative for a number of years now, because we genuinely believe in the power of education to shape lives. This project in particular holds a special place in our hearts because it recognises the crucial role that teachers play in our communities. In our view, education is the cornerstone of progress, and supporting teachers in making a difference is something that we are truly passionate about.
We use all our platforms, the New Vision, Bukede, all our TV stations, all our radio stations, and online. This year when we put out the call, we received over 480 nominations. And out of those, we do send our journalists out. We look for our well-trained journalists, and they go out and look for these teachers and profile them. So out of these 480, we were able to publish 60 stories. Now, out of these 60 stories, that is where the judges, the jury of five distinguished Ugandans selects the 12 winning stories.
Teaching is a noble profession. And why is it noble? Is that whereas we should get worldly rewards, but as teachers, we are waiting for a payment in heaven. The amount of contribution, the kind of work the teachers are doing, no one can reward them. But it's the creator who created the children they are teaching that has more rewards for them. So they can fight and clamor for the words of the year here in the world, but let them be assured. But in any case, I've proved it beyond reasonable doubt that those who do their work very diligently, very committedly, in a way, God rewards them somehow.
many of the teachers are now trying their best to copy from those who have been there and have gone out to spread the good news about new ways of handling educational institutions. It's no longer academically based only. Many of them are advocating for hands-on, and therefore emphasis is being put also on co-curricular activities and community-based approaches, linking up with a number of NGOs in order to improve, to patch up the gaps in the schools.
I have seen the teachers teach children how to grow the vegetables in the backyard, how to have this on their meal. Schools are now looking at how can we feed our children better. So when these things happen, others will look and see what is happening in school Y, school X, and in a little while, we'll find that it's catching up in the country and every region is now embracing this. And we'll find that we have many children who are in school.
The beauty about this contest, when you think about it, since 2008, over 840 teachers recognized. It means that each of these teachers, when their stories are told, it impacts not just the teacher, the school, it impacts the communities and the districts. It's a way of teaching. It's a way of teaching the other teachers that this is what you need to do if you're to be exemplary.
I was no senior woman teacher. I was acting like a senior woman, yet I was not even a senior man. I told them there are some homes without the mother, but the father takes over the roles of the mother. I am heading an ICT department, a school nutrition club, and also health and sanitation, where I work as a first aider, whereby a first aid is part of my tool. I work with it. I move with it in the classes. Routinely, I treat different boarders in the evening. It would be a struggle when you are serving meals. You wait for a war, because the boys could struggle until they jump in the saucepan to scare the girls until the others don't eat. You see a child lying down on the veranda, or a child remaining at home because there's no food at school. So I felt, I told the school, let us plant some food. Until we transformed slowly, slowly, where people have died of 1,000 in hunger, but our school has managed to fight the hunger challenge.
These stories are such amazing stories. They are empowering other teachers, they are empowering what we do as teachers, and also they are laying a standard in the country that this is what a teacher should do.
As a commission in charge of teacher education, I think there is a need to, we have the competence profiles that were developed way back in 2016. They could be becoming obsolete, but at least you have somewhere to begin from. They need to be disseminated properly to the teachers to know what they do. Because the teacher has so many duties. It's not only that area of teaching, because it is assessment of learning, it is co-curricular activities, guidance and counseling is also a duty on its own. Continuous professional development is then quite a number of duties in which there are several tasks that are supposed to be done. So I think we need to disseminate this information and they get to know what they are expected to do, because tomorrow, the areas of interest may change.
To the teachers who didn't make it this year or didn't win this year, I want to say this. Your impact is measurable. Your dedication is commendable. Use this moment as a fuel to keep striving for excellence. Your hard work doesn't go unnoticed. And the journey that you're on is just as important as the destination. Keep inspiring, keep innovating, and most importantly, keep making a difference in the lives of your students.
Since 2017, the Embassy of Ireland in Uganda came on board as partners. They came along with Travel Care, and we really appreciate them, because this type of journalism is very complicated. It's very expensive. You have to comb the country to be able to find the teachers. And they've been putting in funds to enable us to do the journalism, but also to reward the deserving teachers. The gift they came aboard with was to take the winning teachers to Ireland so that they could have an exposure. That travel exposure is very, very good. 22 teachers have gone to Ireland, and we hope that this year again they'll be going, and the exposure is very, very good. So this time round, we went back to the 60 teachers who have won since 2017, and again we profiled those teachers to see who has made the most improvement. And out of that lot, another 3 teachers have been recognized. So this year, we shall be announcing 15 teachers, 12 from the fresh nominations and 3 from the alumni.
They will visit Limerick, which is the home of Ireland's premier teacher training college, and they will undertake classes there. So they will do classes in education, new ways of working. They will also do peer-to-peer learning with other Irish teachers. And then they will get a chance to visit Irish schools and not only see how education is done in Ireland, but also talk to Irish students and teachers for them to bring that experience home. But not only do they do that, but they also bring the Ugandan experience to Ireland. So Ireland also benefits from the teachers visiting.
I'm a proud winner of that. And I traveled to Ireland in that group of 2018. And there is a lot we learn there. You go and you find classroom work is given minimal time. The rest is about physicals, playing games, going into the kitchen to cook, baking, technological activities, so that they are always monitoring them and you really see a lesson has come up. But you can easily tell that this is targeting either the head, or it is targeting the heart, or it is targeting the hands.
The Teachers Making a Difference is one of the projects that we feel most passionate about. It's been very successful over the years. And going forward, I think we would like, very much like, to continue our participation in the initiative or in the project. So yes, we will continue.
For us, working in partnership with the Ministry of Education is very important. And we know the emphasis that the government gives to education. And then working in partnership with the likes of the New Vision and Travel Care. For us, it's a joint effort between government and the private sector. We've just agreed a new 5-year strategy, which education is the cornerstone in our program here. And partnering with New Vision and Travel Care will continue to be a major part of our program.
We appreciate Vision Group Management, the board. We appreciate this, our partners, the Embassy of Ireland in Uganda, Travel Care, and we appreciate the Ministry of Education. In the last 3 years, the Ministry of Education has always recognized this competition, and we really appreciate the moral support they are giving us for this. Of course, the challenge we have right now is that things are a bit more expensive. Development journalism is getting more expensive, and we hope we can get more partners on board to support this type of journalism to go on.
Download the app on App Store or Google Play Store now. Vision Digital Experience, the future of media.